I grew up all over the West, but one of the big influences was growing up in Western Washington in the Lake Stevens area. And we had so many frogs there. I just remember every spring and into the summer, the frogs would just go crazy in our neighborhood. And that's a really vivid memory I have. And that stayed with me. Frogs and toads just make this huge variety of different types of calls. You know, like the canyon tree frog is one of my favorite. It sounds sort of like a sheep bleating. The boreal chorus frog sounds a little bit like running your finger over the edge of a comb. And it's just an infinite, really, variety of sounds. And if you go to our website, you can hear just about every Western frog and toad species. What I do with recording is I record the sounds of animals, and obviously sound is tied to the issue of conservation, because if there are no animals around, there are no sounds. It's a pretty simple equation. According to the World Conservation Union, nearly 1 in 4 mammals, 1 in 8 birds, and 1 in 3 amphibians are threatened with extinction all over the world. And I mean, that's about as final as it gets, you know, and we're certainly not immune to that in the Western United States. If I'm going out in the field, I like to just take everything I can, and so that I can record from a variety of different angles. If I want to record distant species, a parabolic microphone is really helpful. It looks like a big radar dish, so people give you some funny looks when you carry that thing around. That's able to capture birds or frogs from, you know, even as far as practically a mile away. The parabolic microphone is very directional. Sometimes I have little lapel mics that I'll place in places, or, you know, drop them down into a beehive or sneak them into a mouse hole or something. It just depends on what you're trying to get. Well, there's a lot of times you'll set up a microphone out at night, and you'll leave the recorder going overnight, and you'll pick up some sound that you have no idea what it is. And there are still some sounds on that I recorded where I honestly don't know what species made it. But almost any time I turn on the tape recorder, I get something unexpected. The pronghorns are an interesting one. Sounds sort of like a ricochet. I'd never really heard a pronghorn before, so sort of a revelation to me when I made a recording. Now I know what a pronghorn sounds like. And the mammals are pretty difficult because, you know, first of all, you have to identify them, and they're not vocal that often. They're usually hard to find, and that's one of the things where you have to time it just right, you know. You've really got a small window for making recordings, and I think that's the case with almost any species. So if you hear a sound, you're really lucky. You know, you shouldn't take that for granted, because, you know, that means you were in the right place at the right time. I have a lot of favorite sounds. The sounds that I like isn't always necessarily about how beautiful they are. It's more just what they mean to me. I really love the northern grasshopper mouse, but it's not the kind of sound that you're going to put on a CD for easy listening or something. It's this high-pitched, squeaky sound. But I just love what it represents. The biggest thing, you know, that interests me is just the variety of sounds, you know. Who knew what a beaver sounded like? Or who knew what a nutria sounded like? Or a Gila monster? And I just think that it's really interesting. It tells you a lot about the species. It just opens up a lot of doors for better understanding of the natural world.